Hi everyone, welcome back. We're going to continue with text analytics. Specifically, we're going to talk about latent semantic indexing and also this underlying mathematical tool called Singular Value Decomposition, or SVD for short. And we'll learn about how it is a tool that can help us discover topics in a large document collection. So given a large document collection, we often want to find the common themes in the document so that we can more easily understand what's in them. And finding such themes or concept is what latent semantic indexing, or LSI for short, can do for us. And the main idea is that we map each document into some sort of concept. And also, for each term or each word, we also map into the concept. And here, concept is loosely defined as, say, a set of terms and with their corresponding weights. So for example, let's say we have a concept called DBMS, so Database Management System. And the concept here would be characterized by the words that it contains. So let's say for the word data, we have, say, a weight of 0.8. The word system, we have the weight of 0.5, retrieval 0.6, and so on. So something to note that is that LSI actually doesn't give us a name, DBMS. But from the term weight, like 0.8, 0.5, and so on, we can actually figure out quite easily what that concept is. So here, let's say data, okay, it's probably about data analysis system. So that means data analysis and system. So likely, it's probably about DBMS. So what LSI can do for us is to decompose our original matrix into two smaller matrices. The first one is term concept matrix, and the other is a document concept matrix. So the notion of concept is what LSI introduced to us. And here we have two concepts. The first one is database management concept. The other is medical concept. And also LSI would tell us the weight. So for example, in the first term concept matrix, so those are what we call the term weight for each concept. And similarly, in the document concept matrix, we also have the weight for the document relative to the concept. So the benefit of having these two matrices is that LSI gives us a sophisticated way to do document retrieval that goes beyond exact word matching. So for example, let's say we want to find the documents that are related to the word system. So in our retrieval process, we first make use of the first matrix, the term concept matrix, to figure out which concept the word system is most strongly associated with. And then we use the second matrix, the document concept matrix. In this case, we see that the document 1 and document 2 has a really strong weight of associated with the database concept. So in other words, you can think of it as some sort of lookup where we start with our query, which is a word system, and then we figure out which concept is the most strongly associated with the word system, in this case, database concept, and then we jump to the second matrix, right, using our intermediate result that out. So database concept is what we're interested in, and using this idea to retrieve the documents that are most associated with that concept. And what that means is LSI works more or less like an automatically constructed thesaurus. And it's very powerful in that we can retrieve documents that don't even include the word system, but contains almost everything else, right? Because there's an intermediate step we just saw where we first map our query, which is the word system, into some sort of like a concept association. And using that notion of concept association, then we jump to the documents that are most associated with it. So that means that using this middle step, we actually can go beyond the traditional kind of exact match, word exact match approach. So a short recap is that LSI is a great idea because it can help us derive these concepts among documents. So we haven't talked about that yet, but we will very shortly. And then what we saw also is the application of LSI, which is that it essentially builds some sort of like thesaurus automatically. And also by using it, we can do retrieval that go beyond exact match. And also later on, we'll learn that through LSI, we can actually also get a ranking of the discovered concepts, which would allow us to throw away the less important concept. So doing essentially what we call dimensionality reduction. So we'll look at all of these. So, but the very first question is, like, LSI is great, but how does it work? So it uses a mathematical tool called singular value decomposition, or SVD for short. So SVD is a very powerful and generalizable technique that can help us solve important problems, such as like finding concepts, as in the example on the right, and also similar to what we discussed. So in this example here, we say we are looking at transactions among people at a grocery store, right? So each row is a customer, and each column is a product. So also, again, eyeballing it, you see the first group of customers, probably they're vegetarians, they mainly buy vegetables. And then another group would be, say, meat eaters, so they buy like chicken and beef. Right? So finding these kind of concepts. And then also the second problem that LSI or SVD can solve is through finding these concepts, we can actually rank the concept and potentially throw away the less important ones so that we can store our data more efficiently. And also we'll see that there's a strong relationship between dimensionary reduction or throwing away information to compression and also recommendation. So one thing to note is that I keep saying SVD is a very powerful and generalizable technique. The reason is that all it takes is a matrix of numbers. So it doesn't really care how you generate that matrix. For example, what we saw previously was each row is a customer, and then the columns would be like grocery store item. But there's no stopping you from using another matrix. Let's say if you are like Pandora, for example, then your data would be customers and songs. So that means the columns now can be songs. And similarly, let's say if you're Netflix, then your columns can be movies. So that means it's really anything you can use. And no matter what matrix you put in, it's able to help you discover these topics or groups of concepts. So for that reason, it's really, really powerful. So now we can dig deeper into what SVD can do. So we'll start with like a picture, a pictorial description of SVD, and then we'll look into it in a more technical sense. So at a high level, SVD, what it does is it decomposes our data matrix A. So in the red box up there, we have an A matrix, which is N by M. So let's say we're looking at text documents. So N is the number of documents, and M is the number of terms or words among these documents. So that's our input matrix A. And what SVD can do is it can decompose this matrix into three smaller matrices, U, lambda, and V. So the first matrix, U, is N by R. So N, still the same number of documents. R is what LSI would be able to give you. So it's R number of concepts. And also similarly, for the V matrix, is R by M. So R, again, is the number of concepts, and M is the same as our original data matrix, so the number of terms. Also interestingly, what we haven't talked about so far is the middle matrix, so which is R by R. So R is the number of concepts. And the very interesting thing about this matrix is a diagonal matrix. So that means only the diagonal entries are non-zero. And also, not only that, the values along the diagonal actually encode the concept string. So also, they are ordered. So the concept with the greatest strength or strongest strength will be at the top left, and the one that has the smallest string will be at the lower right. So that means you have a ranked list of concept strength going along the diagonal. So putting in words, so that means we have our A matrix, N by M, let's say N documents, M terms, and then we decompose that into three smaller matrices, U matrix, N by R, let's say N documents, R concepts, a very special lambda matrix, R by R. So the number R is actually also the rank of our original matrix A, so actually one pretty good use of SVD is to try to compute the rank or the effective rank of our original matrix. And also we notice that these R entries, they are ranked in the order of strength. And thirdly, we have our V matrix, which is M by R, M terms, R concepts. There's actually a theorem that says it's always possible to decompose our data matrix A into the three smaller matrices, and they are unique most of the time. And not only that, U and V, the columns in those matrices are orthonormal, so meaning the columns are unit vectors, and they are also orthogonal to each other. So one natural outcome of it is if you do U transpose U, it'll give you an identity matrix. And similarly for V transpose V, it'll also give you an identity matrix. And we said before, lambda would be diagonal matrix with non-negative diagonal entries, and also interestingly sorted in decreasing order. You will see why this order is important very shortly. So let's look at a numerical example of what SVD can do. So here the rows are documents and columns are words in the document. So cell values are word counts, but as you may recall, it can be anything. It can be like 0 and 1 to express the existence of words, or they can be TF-IDF scores. So here we're just using word count for simplicity. So let's look at the matrices and their cell values, and let's understand how to interpret them. So let's check their dimensions. So the first matrix is the U matrix. Has a number of rows, right, that's the same as the number of documents. And also, the number of columns here is the concepts. And so concept, there are two, because it's actually also the rank of our original matrix, which if you're just eyeballing it, you know the rank is 2. And then we have the middle matrix, our lambda matrix. So it's R by R. So since R is 2, so it's also 2 by 2. And the third matrix is the U matrix. So it has the same number of words as in our original matrix, so 5. And then number of rows equals the number of concepts, which is 2. So those are the dimensions. So they make sense, all of them. They all add up. And next, we can look at the values. So in the U matrix, the first concept, or the first column, so if you look at the values, so the value seems to scale somewhat proportionally with the word counts in our original matrix, right? So we say 0.18, 0.36, and so on. And this seems to make sense, right? Because for example, let's say for document 4, which is row 4 in our original matrix, the word data appear 5 times, right? And information appear 5 times, retrieval 5 times, and so on. And in our U matrix, you will see that we have a 0.9 value, right, which is the biggest value in that column. And it seems to make sense. It correlates with the word count in our original data matrix. So that's a very plausible thing that we observe, meaning that particular document, document number 4, is strongly associated with the CS concept. So similarly, in our context, we can interpret the matrix U, the document concept similarity matrix, in a similar way, right? So here, if we have a higher number, that means it's more similar or more strongly associated with that concept. And for the second matrix, the lambda matrix, here we can see that it's a diagonal matrix, and also the diagonal entries are non-zero. And also, we see that they're sorted, right? So 9.64, that's the strength of the CS concept. And 5.29, that's the second one, which is a smaller concept for the medical documents. So there's another way to interpret these matrices. The first one, the U matrix, we can call it the document concept simulator matrix. So that means the values here encode similarity. So higher the value, more similar a document is to a concept. And similarly, for the V matrix, we can also call it the term concept simulator matrix. So the bigger the value, the more similar a term is to a concept. In this video, we'll learn about LSI and also its underlying mathematical tool SVD, singular value decomposition. And we mentioned that it's a very generalizable technique because it only requires the input to be a matrix, and then it can automatically discover concepts or themes in your data.